Dean Ettinger is the guest performer. Ever wonder where all the actors come from? More than 200 came from the Sacramento area to McClatchy High School this weekend for the Sacramento Children's Theater version of the Broadway hit musical Annie. At the opening tonight, all the stars arrived in limos, with searchlights streaking the sky and fans crowding around, probably looking for autographs. It's the largest cast of orphans you'll ever see in Annie, I bet. Sacramento Children's Theater builds self-confidence and brings a little culture to your kids. This weekend, they return the favor. 2 p.m. and 7 p.m. performances at C.K. McClatchy Senior High School, Saturday and Sunday. General admission is $7.
How can you resist them? They were awfully cute.
200 of them.
200.
Sacramento Children's Theater is pleased to welcome you to its gala premiere of the hit Broadway musical, Annie.
Thank you. Thank you. I will never know.
It's all right.
Thank you. Greg, call your guest. And whoever they touch it, I now they are blessed with thy blessed with heaven. Thousands of wonderful Americans are now living in makeshift towns on Hoover Bell. Hey, Al, how's it going?
How'd it go, he says? I'll tell you, there's 7 million people in this town. Now, can you sell 1,000 apples?
And in New York City now, there are more than a dozen in Hoovervale, Riverside Drive, Central Park, and here we are, 59th Street Grand.
Breathing fingers. For
blankets?
Thank you. And now CBS Radio brings you Bob Perkins. Bob's daughter Ray is going to marry Carl Michaels. On Friday, Carl went back to Chicago. No sooner had Carl left town than Dr. Andrews.
Oh, Jack, man!
Miss Hannigan. Oh. Good afternoon. Miss Hannigan, is it?
Yes.
I'd like to inform, ma'am. Oh. We found your orphan.
Oh.
We found your family, what are they? Over hills, under the river, by the river.
Oh.
And there was a bunch of others with her.
There was not!
She had a name, she went with her too. And he got away.
Oh, oh, dear. Poor pumpkin. Out in the rain and cold with just that thin sweater on. I hope they didn't catch him. Oh, what's that? Thanks again.
And you. I don't ever want to hear you running away again. Not from this.
Oh, sign it. Oh, sign it. Ah, easy on the line.
from Chicago and Cleveland, so we are expecting him at any moment.
Do you really live here? Or is this a train station?
We really live here. Oh, has the common been put down in the dining room, Mrs. Greer?
Yes, ma'am.
And has the dining room been too?
Yes, ma'am.
Everything is in order. I've had a few men's favorite dinner.
Fine. It would be good to see the door open again.
Yes, 6 weeks is a very long time.
Yes, sir.
Would you all come here for a moment, please?
Quickly, everyone, quickly.
Everyone, I'd like to meet Abby. The orphan will be with us for the next 2 weeks for Christmas.
Abby is?
This is everyone.
Hi, everyone!
May I take your compass?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
Gee, I really love your compass, Sarah.
I'm so glad, Abby. Now, what would you like to do first?
The floor. I'll do it back. And now it's
Abby, you won't have to do any of that while you're here.
I won't?
Of course not. You're our guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time.
Thank you.
And, who is that?
This is Daddy, Mr. Roberts. The orphan will be with us for the next 2 weeks.
The orphan? But orphans are boys.
Oh.
And that's not a boy.
I am sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose her.
Oh, well then I suppose you'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
What's your last name, child?
Oh, I'm just Annie, sir. Mr. Warbeck, I haven't got any last name.
So you're just Annie, huh?
Just sorry about a boy.
I don't suppose you'd like to meet Lou Gehrig.
Oh, boy, sure!
Who's Lou Gehrig?
I couldn't be happier, Annie, that you'd be spending the Christmas holiday with us. I'll grace we'll start with the iron ore shipments, first of all. And then we'll pass and the oil drums to the Carnegie Center. What are we supposed to do with this child?
It is your first night here, sir.
Oh. It's your first night here, Annie. I guess I ought to do something special for you. Why don't you sit down?
Thank you.
again, we bring you Romance of Helen Trent. She sets out to prove for herself what so many women long to prove, that just because a woman is 34, 5 or more, the romance in life need not be over. The romance can live at 35 and after.
Mercy God, I hope so. It's the warm but still night to the bed, and Annie is having the time of her life. How nice! Yes. She and Mr. Walmart are practically inseparable. They go everywhere together, to the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange. Guess where they had lunch yesterday? The Walmart. The Ottomans. Yes. And she just loves her new coat. She never takes it off. Never. Miss Hattie,
I know you're busy, but
these papers must be signed and taken back to Mr. Donatelli at the Hall of Audience by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Well, because Mr. Walters is so taken with Annette. Guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
How nice.
How wonderful! Now let me hit this one a little bit straight. Annie's gonna be Walmart's kid. The daughter of a millionaire.
Oh, no, no! The daughter of a billionaire.
A billionaire! And Mr. Walmart's asked me to drop by in person to tell you that Annie won't be coming back here. Ever.
Ever?
$80 coming in the mail.
Will you? No, I'm not asking you for your help. I've never asked any man for his help, and I'll never ask you. Yes, fine. Mr. President, why don't you come over? We'll discuss it on
Friday.
Yes, Mr. President, why don't you and Mrs. Roosevelt come over here for supper on your way to Hyde Park? Yes, well, fine. Wonderful, Mr. President. Goodbye. If I would have known he was going to say yes, I would have never asked him. Grace, what else did to find out what Democrats eat? Friday morning, 11 a.m., meeting at the White House with President Roosevelt. Did you get packages?
Oh, yes, sir, right this morning.
Right. I'm going to give this thing to Annie and tell her that I want to adopt her. Where is Annie?
She's upstairs in the room, writing another letter to a friend in the office. I'll have Grace hold it out.
Fine.
You don't have to be worried, sir. She's going to be the happiest girl in the world.
And I'm not nervous, even. Get her down here, Grace.
Yes, sir. Grace?
Yes.
Mr. Walnut will see Annie now.
Yes. Miss Annie, Mr. Walnut, see you.
Thank you, Mr. Grace. Hello.
Hello, Annie.
Hello, Annie. How are you today?
Fine, thank you. How are you, sir?
Fine. Annie, the time has come for the two of us to have a very serious discussion.
To send me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
Sure. Locket! I don't want a new one!
What's the matter, Annie?
This locket! When I
I'll get her a brandy.
It's going to be all right.
Don't you worry, Miss Patty. Anyone can find your herd, Mr. Wallace.
That's right. Mr. Wallace will find your parents if he has to pull every political string there is to pull, up to and including the White House.
The lead of nation.
If he should need the FBI, then he will have the FBI.
December 31st, 1922.
are presently conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents.
Gansberg, Healy, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for anyone who can prove that they are Annie's parents. And furthermore, I am offering a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents.
$50,000? Wow, Oliver Warbucks. Annie's parents, if you're out there listening, contact Oliver Warbucks at this station, WEAF, New York, New York, or write him directly at
my home, Bird Healy, 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
That's 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
Thank you, Bird Healy. I would now like to take this time to thank the miracle makers of Miracle K64 Octoline Toothpaste to Fight Bad Breath for letting me appear here this evening on this radio station. Thank you, Bert Healy. Drop page.
Thank you. Flying spirits, if you're out there listening, there's $50,000 and a wonderful daughter just waiting for you, so get in touch right away. You hear? Well, I see my little plug on the wall, and another word Thursday night gets you has gone by faster than you can say oxygen.
O-S-Y-G-E-N-T!
So all the Our Smiles family, Bonnie, 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 Stella, Steffi, and Starlight, the wonderful Boylan sisters, this is Bert Eady.
Yeah.
$50,000. But I couldn't do with $50,000. God, it's illegal.
Excuse us, ma'am. Are you the lady that brought us into your office?
Yeah, what do you want?
Oh, Rail! I'm scared! Something's gonna happen to her!
Oh, hush, son. Everything's gonna be all right, sir. She's gonna be here and she's gonna be out again. Ma'am, was you working here 11 years ago?
Yeah.
Well, you see, we had terrible trouble back then. And we had to head north up to Canada. So we had to leave our little baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl! Our... Annie!
Annie? You're Annie's parents?
Yes, ma'am, we are.
Please, what has happened to us?
God! Can't believe it! Annie, Harry. Where'd you say you come from again?
Oh, from a little farm up in Canada, where they got lots of chickens and ducks and geese and roosters! Gotcha!
President, this is my good friend Annie. She so wanted to meet you.
I couldn't resist bringing her along, just to say hello. Annie, this is President Roosevelt.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sound on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Yes, Oliver. Annie, can wait outside.
Oh, no, Oliver, let me add you today. Having a child on hand will keep us both on our best behavior.
Yes, Franklin, if you don't mind. In the words of the great Calvinist, the business of this country is business, and for the good of you, the country, and Wall Street, and me, of course. We've got to get my workers back to work and my factories open. Now let's see, according to my latest figures, there are at least 15 million Americans who are unemployed, and 50 more million Americans with no physical means of support.
Oliver, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem. It is facts of Germany becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany, help, Franklin. There are people in America who are starving.
Well, at least we're agreed on one thing. The situation is hopeless, getting worse.
Outside of the house, all claiming to be Annie's parents. Begun to
suggest your attorney call the one signed Grace Farrell.
Well, looks as though the hour smiles has more listeners than we thought. Time.
Gee, how did it happen? What is this about to be my mother and father?
Well, Oliver, as much as I enjoy your company, and especially yours, Annie, I expect you better be getting back to the old ones.
Oh, yes, Mr. President, if you don't mind.
Thank you.
your games. There's something else you should know.
Yes, sir. guests at Annie's adoption party.
Rip it up!
Just stop!
Oh, can't fit!
Oh, yes. I'm afraid it'll be way past the kids' bedtime. But I'll tell you what, we'll have all the kids over first thing in the morning. Miss Annie, too. Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last.
Together at last.
We're coming to the dawn.
but you are Aunt Mudge.
Mudge. We were thinking rope, honey, and we didn't know which way to turn. And then a man, he gave us a chance to work on his farm up in Canada.
But we couldn't bring along no money.
We loved you, Annie, honey, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, we've seen a great number of people.
I expected you wanted some proof. Like, here's Annie's birth certificate.
Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, on October 28, 1942, New York, New York.
October 28th. That's my birthday.
It was in her letter, sir.
I understand all that.
Please, Mister, you gotta believe us. We just got in on the Greyhound bus this afternoon, and we went straight on over to the orphanage. But the lady there said our Annie was up here.
Oh, Annie! Over here, my dream, the hole in you in my heart, again!
Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie was...
And here's something else that you wouldn't know about. But when we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half a silver locket with her and cut the other half so that when we came back...
Oh, the real river! Annie's buried!
And here's the body here! And look, it fits perfectly!
No,
oh, she is, she is. And if you'll be getting her things back together, you'll be taking her along now.
Take?
No, not yet.
What about the money?
Money? Oh, well, we ain't got much. But we'd be glad to give you whatever.
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check of $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's real parents.
We don't know nothing about no check. Well, anyway, we don't want no money.
Right. We don't want no money.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? Well, with $50,000, we could afford to bring Annie up right in the country with fresh air. Fresh eggs.
Fresh ham.
Fresh air. All I gotta do is make the check out to myself.
Yes, that's right. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
That's right. Tomorrow. You can pick up any other papers in the morning.
Ah.
Oh, well, yes. Whatever you prefer, sir. Well, I think we better be getting back to our hotel now. Bye.
Bye, Aunt Love.
Until tomorrow morning. And then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Well, goodbye, Aunt.
Oops. Pardon me, Susie.
Merry Christmas.
Season's greetings.
Well, this is wonderful news.
Right. I'm lucky. Just think. New Jersey.
Addie's found you. Drink
the champion.
As I was saying before, we must celebrate. Because Addie's heard the most wonderful news in the world.
Found her real mother and father.
I'd like to propose a toast to my Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Annie!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas.
I seem to have the same effect on everyone. I've lost her.
being I've seen in some place before. I just can't figure out where or when. But I have a feeling he's not the man who he says he is.
Frank. Mr. President. I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do.
States, and this is my mother, Drake. And this is my butler.
Beginning of a new and wonderful.